damage and destruction as a brutal Christmas storm slams southeast Queensland. Roofs ripped from homes and trees sent flying. The most iconic date in the Australian sport arrives. The Boxing Day test will be full of heart. The royal family celebrates Christmas. Familiar faces, old and new, come together. And ready, set, shop. Aussies tip to spend big in the Boxing Day sales. Good morning. It's been a destructive and deadly Christmas night in southeast Queensland, pounded by a severe thunderstorm. Extreme winds, giant hail and lightning stirred mayhem, causing trees to topple onto homes and cars and ripping roofs from houses. The Gold Coast, Logan and Scenic Rim have been worst hit, with reports of over half an hour of continuous lightning there. Emergency crews have also been dealing with down lines, cutting power to more than 100,000 properties.
It was that insane. I told her to run for cover, and it just, man, I never seen trees touch the ground, eh? And this tree here, and like a big gum tree across my place here, streets my house. And then you can walk down the rest of the street, and the fences are blowing out.
Wind gusts in excess of 125 kilometres an hour have been recorded. That's equivalent to a Category 2 cyclone. And severe weather alerts are extending across the east coast. More wet and wild conditions will follow a Christmas deluge in Victoria, where thunderstorms are expected to strike before the new year. There were more than 600 calls for help to the SES yesterday, including for damage to roofs and for flooding. Several towns across the state recorded new Christmas Day rainfall records. New South Wales also felt the full force of the severe Christmas weather. This is Grenfell in the state's central west, where giant hailstones delivered a very unconventional white Christmas. Sydney's eastern suburbs was also hit by heavy rains and flash flooding. In Botany, it submerged cars and washed out parts of Bondi Beach. It also caused headaches at Sydney Airport, forcing 20 flights to be delayed or diverted. It's one of the biggest events on Australia's sporting calendar, and the Boxing Day test will be full of heart. Australia hosts Pakistan at the MCG in the second test of the series after taking the lead in Perth. This year's test will feature the legacy of the late Shane Warne, kick-starting a new campaign to tackle heart disease. Free tests will be available to fans to check their heart health. Well, tough conditions are expected for Australia's most famous race on the water, the Sydney Hobart. Set for 1 p.m. start on Sydney Harbour, rain, strong winds and even hail could make for an especially challenging race this year, particularly in the latter stages. Sailors have also been told to keep an eye out for sunfish and other potential obstacles in the water. Four supermaxis are the big contenders for line otters, including defending in champ Comanche. Well, after the Christmas shopping rush, retailers are tipped to cash in from the Boxing Day sales. The Australian Retailers Association predicts up to $9 billion will be spent by shoppers up to the new year, despite the effects of inflation and multiple interest rate hikes. After recent sales events for Christmas and Black Friday, experts say shoppers are likely to splurge on themselves this time around instead of focusing on gifting for others. The NRL community has been rocked by the news of the death of Raiders recruit Troy Dargan. The former Rabbitohs utility had been on holiday with his family in the Cook Islands, where he was involved in a motorcycle accident on Christmas Eve. Dargan had previously been in a player development roles with the Brisbane Broncos and Parramatta Eels and recently played in the New South Wales Cup. He signed with the Raiders just last month. He was 26. The royal family spent Christmas together attending a church service at Sandringham. King Charles and Queen Camilla were joined by the Prince and Princess of Wales and their three children and spent time greeting crowds. The Duke and Duchess of Edinburgh were also there, as well as Princess Anne. Prince Andrew also made an appearance and was accompanied by ex-wife Sarah Ferguson for the first time in years. Well, the King's appearance at the church service was just hours before his Christmas message was officially broadcast, calling for care, compassion and service. Charles also focused on the shared ideals of the world's faiths after a year of escalating religious tensions.
The King's first Christmas broadcast from Buckingham Palace. His Majesty delivering his message with a view to the Queen Victoria Memorial.
For some, faith will be uppermost in their hearts. For others, it will be the joy of fellowship and the giving of presents. It is also a time when we remember those who are no longer with us.
His late mother would often be accompanied by carefully arranged family photos, Charles choosing video to depict the work of the small group of royals still carrying out official duties, the Duke and Duchess of Edinburgh, Princess Anne, and featuring heavily the Waleses.
Throughout the year, my family have witnessed how people of all ages are making a difference to their communities. This is all the more important at a time of real hardship for many, when we need to build on existing ways to support others less fortunate than ourselves.
Highlighting the hundreds of volunteers and community leaders who were invited to Their Majesty's May coronation.
Their presence meant so much to us both and emphasised the meaning of coronation itself. Above all, a call to all of us to serve one another.
There is a call to arms on the environment too.
To care for this creation is a responsibility owned by people of all faiths and of none.
The King overwhelmingly focusing on the religious-based message Christmas offers, but highlighting the common ideals between Christians, Jews and Muslims, the Abrahamic faiths, at a time of conflict.
They remind us to imagine ourselves in the shoes of our neighbours and to seek their good as we would our own. I wish you a Christmas of peace on earth and goodwill to all, today and always.
In London, Hugh Whitfeld, 7 News.
A quick check of sport now. The countdown is on for Australia's heavily anticipated Boxing Day test against Pakistan today. Despite ongoing predictions of wet weather, skipper Pat Cummins isn't worried ahead of today's proceedings.
Test matches here seem to move a little bit quicker than other places in the last few years, so I think there'll be plenty of time to finish the game and, don't think it'll change any.
And you can catch all the Boxing Day test action live and free right here on 7. Coverage begins from 9:30. Usman Khawaja has slammed the ICC after being denied another application to display a symbol for today's Boxing Day test. Khawaja hoped to don a sticker of a black dove, a symbol of peace, on his gear for the test match, but was once again rejected by the council. The star opener took to Instagram last night, calling out the double standards, including an image of teammate Manus Labuschagne, who has previously played with an eagle and Bible verse on his bat. It's the second time Khawaja has been denied by cricket's governing body. Checking Tuesday's weather now for Boxing Day around the capital. Showers and a possible storm in Brisbane, 33 degrees. A shower or two for Sydney, 28. A storm on the way for Canberra, 26 there. Showers increasing in Melbourne, a top of 25. Mostly sunny for Hobart today, 23 degrees. A possible shower and 22 in Adelaide. Perth partly cloudy and 27. And a storm possible in Darwin, 35 degrees. For your company on 7's Early News, these are the stories we're following. Southeast Queensland has been pummeled by a Christmas night storm, knocking down trees and ripping roofs from homes. Free heart health tests will be available for fans at the Boxing Day test in Melbourne in honour of Shane Warne. And sailors in the Sydney Hobart are being warned of tougher conditions this year as they prepare to race today. A new poll has revealed Queensland's new era in leadership has made no difference for Labor's chances at the upcoming state election. Opposition leader David Crisafulli remains the front-runner for preferred premier, in spite of Stephen Miles's tussle to the top. More than half of the voters polled believed Mr Crisafulli would be a better premier, while 47.8% were in favour of Miles. St Vincent's Health says it's still in the dark about whether hackers stole private medical data. Nearly a week after the network's hospitals were hit in a cyber attack, St Vincent's has revealed it's unsure whether health records were taken. The organisation has come under fire from unions and medical bodies over claims it failed to protect sensitive information belonging to patients. Pope Francis has devoted his blessing for Christmas Day to a call for world peace. The pontiff addressed a crowd of thousands at the Vatican with an appeal for humanitarian initiatives and dialogue to triumph over death and violence. In Bethlehem, locals gathered for a mass at the spot where Christians believe Jesus was born. but the city remains subdued as the war in the Middle East rages. Health officials in Gaza say at least 78 people have been killed in Israeli airstrikes on a refugee camp. It represents one of the deadliest nights on the Strip since Israel's war with Hamas flared up in October. It's claimed women and children were among those killed. Meanwhile, Israel's Benjamin Netanyahu has dismissed claims he may call for a pause in fighting, vowing that Israel will not stop. After being stranded in an airport in rural France for 4 days, a plane load of Indian citizens are being flown to Mumbai. More than 300 people were caught up in the ordeal after two passengers were detained over a human trafficking investigation. Their flight had been en route from the UAE to Nicaragua when it was grounded after French police received an anonymous tip-off. Australia's serving men and women spending Christmas away from their families have sent messages to lift the spirits of loved ones back home. Many defence personnel have taken up new positions in the Middle East this year due to the conflict in Gaza.
Flight Lieutenant Matthew Bogrowski is spending Christmas at a secret location in the Middle East.
With my personal experience, it's been quite challenging, however quite rewarding in the area. And doing the work that I do.
He's part of a group of Australian troops sent to monitor the conflict in Israel, ready to evacuate thousands of Aussies in the region if the war escalates.
I am definitely proud to be wearing this uniform overseas.
He wanted to send this message to family and friends back home.
All their mail and little Christmas gifts that they've sent, appreciate it. Thank you very much. Merry Christmas.
More than 1,000 Australian Defence Force personnel are currently deployed overseas, missing the holidays with loved ones.
I'm currently deployed to the Sinai, Egypt. I'd like to wish a very special Merry Christmas to my friends and family back home.
I love you, I miss you, and I'll see you very soon.
Currently deployed to southern Lebanon. I wish you a very Merry Christmas.
To my friends, family, and my son Archer and my daughter Shaylin, Merry Christmas.
Hopefully you'll get a big surprise when I get back next year. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Many have spent the year in Europe training new recruits into the Ukrainian armed forces in what's becoming a protracted conflict.
Merry Christmas, family. Enjoy the beach and I'll enjoy the snow.
Hope you guys have a great Christmas. Dad loves you and I'll see you soon.
The Defence Force has also been helping our Pacific neighbours. On the Solomon Islands, their Christmas spirit is unwavered.
I just want to wish my family and friends back home in Brisbane a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. I love you all. Just hoping to wish my lovely partner a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, as well as all my family and friends.
Wishing family and friends a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Have a beer on me.
It's not just soldiers. Contractors are also stationed abroad, looking after troops in camps.
Hey, it's Dr. Pete here, the Army doctor over in the Middle East region. Just wishing you all a Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. I love you and I'll see you soon.
2023 has been a huge year of enormous achievement and everyone in the defence family can feel intensely proud.
Defence operations are expected to ramp up in the coming years as Australia acquires nuclear-powered submarines and conflict moves closer to home. But for now, from the defence family to yours.
Merry Christmas!
Jennifer Beshwati, 7 News.
Australian music legend John Farnham has celebrated Christmas with his family in the first sighting since the singer was diagnosed with cancer in 2022. Whispering Jack was pictured at the head of the table 4 months after declaring he's cancer-free. In his first personal statement since having mouth surgery, the 74-year-old said he was finally in the comfort of his own home and felt like the luckiest man I know.